everyone is doing good. So today let's start our third kingdom, Kingdom Fungi. The fungi constitute a unique kingdom of heterotrophic organisms. They show a great diversity in morphology and habitat. You must have seen fungi on a moist bread and rotten roots. The common mushroom you eat and toadstools are also fungi. White spots seen on mustard leaves are due to a parasitic fungus. Some unicellular fungi, example yeast, are used to make bread and beer. Other fungi causing diseases in plants and animals, wheat rust causing Pyxenia is an important example. Some are sources of antibiotics, example penicillium. Fungi are cosmopolitan and occur in air, water, soil and on animals and plants. They prefer to grow in warm and humid places. Have you ever wondered why we keep food in the refrigerator? Yes, it is to prevent food from going bad due to bacterial or fungal infections. With the exceptions of yeast, which are unicellular, fungi are filamentous. Their bodies consist of long, slender, thread-like structures called hyphae. The network of hyphae is also known as mycelium. Some hyphae are continuous tubes filled with multinucleated cytoplasm. These are called cenocytic hyphae. Others have septi or cross walls in their hyphae. The cell walls of fungi are composed of chitin and polysaccharides. Most fungi are heterotrophic and absorb soluble organic matter from dead substrates and hence are called saprophytes. Those that depend on living plants and animals are called parasites. They can also live as symbionts in association with algae as lichens and with roots of higher plants as mycorrhiza. Reproduction in fungi can take place by vegetative means, fragmentation, fission, and budding. Asexual reproduction is by spores called conidia or sporangiospores or zoospores. And sexual reproduction is by oospores, ascospores and basidiospores. The various spores are produced in distinct structures called fruiting bodies. The sexual cycle involves the following three steps. Step number one, fusion of protoplasm between two motile or non-motile gametes called plasmogamy. Step number two, fusion of two nuclei called karyogamy. Step number three, meiosis in zygote resulting in haploid spores. When a fungus reproduces sexually, two haploid hyphae or compatible mating types come together and fuse. In some fungi, the fusion of two haploid cells immediately results in diploid cells, 2N, which represents diploid cell. However, in other fungi, ascomycetes and basidiomycetes, an intervening dikaryotic stage, N plus N, that is two nuclei per cell, occurs. Such a condition is called a dikaryon, and the phase is called dikaryophase of fungus. Later, the parental nuclei fuse and cells become diploid. The fungi form fruiting bodies in which the reduction division occurs, leading to the formation of a haploid spores. Figure on the right hand side represents muco. Point number one, the morphology of the mycelium. Two, mode of spore formation. And third, fruiting bodies form the basis for the division of kingdom into various classes. Class number one under fungi is Phycomycetes. Members of Phycomycetes are found in aquatic habitats and on decaying wood in moist and damp places or as obligate parasites on plants. The mycelium is aseptate and cenocytic. Asexual reproduction takes place by zoospores motile or by aplanospores non-motile. These spores are endogenously produced in sporangium. A zygospore is formed by fusion of two gametes. These gametes are similar in morphology, isogamous or dissimilar, anisogamous or oogamous. Some common examples are mucor, rhizopus, the bread mold, and albugo, the parasitic fungi on mustard. Figure number B represents Aspergillus, which comes under Ascomycetes, and figure number C represents Agaricus, which comes under Basidiomycetes. Class number 2 of fungi is Ascomycetes, commonly known as sac fungi. The Ascomycetes are mostly multicellular, example Penicillium, or really unicellular, example is Saccharomyces. They are saprophytic, decomposers, parasitic, or coprophilous, growing on tongue. Mycelium is branched and septate. The asexual spores are conidia, produced exogenously on the special mycelium called conidiophores. Conidia on germination produce mycelium. Sexual spores are called ascospores, which are produced endogenously in sac-like SI, singular ascus. These SI are arranged in different types of fruiting bodies, ascocarps. Some examples are Aspergillus, Claviceps, and Neurospora. Neurospora is used extensively in biochemical and genetic work. Many members like morels and truffles are edibles and are considered delicious. Third class of fungi is Basidiomycetes. Commonly known form of Basidiomycetes are mushrooms, bracket fungi, or puffballs. They grow in soil on logs and tree stumps and in living plant bodies as parasites, example rusts and smuts. The mycelium is branched and septate. The asexual spores are generally not found, but vegetative reproduction by fragmentation is common. The sex organs are absent. Underline this word absent, it is very important. But plasmogamy is brought about by fusion of two vegetative or somatic cells of different strains or genotypes. The resultant structure is dikaryotic, which ultimately gives rise to basidium. Karyogamy and meiosis takes place in the basidium, producing four basidiospores. The basidiospores are exogenously produced on the basidium. The basidia are arranged in fruiting body called basidiocarps. Some common members are Agaricus, mushroom, Ostilago, smut, and Pucina, rust fungi. Pronunciation mein kuch difference ho sakta hai, but please adjust. Now fourth class of fungi and the last one is Deuteromycetes, commonly called as imperfect fungi because only the asexual or vegetative phases of these fungi are known. When the sexual form of these fungi were discovered, they were moved into classes they rightly belonged to. It is also possible that the asexual or vegetative stage have been given one name and placed under Deuteromycetes, and the sexual stage another and placed under another class. Later, when the linkages were established, the fungi were correctly identified and moved out of Deuteromycetes. Once perfect, sexual stages of members of Deuteromycetes were discovered, they were often moved to Ascomycetes and Basidiomycetes. The Deuteromycetes reproduce only by asexual spores known as conidia. The mycelium is septate and branched. Some members are saprophytes or parasites. While a large number of them are decomposers of litter and help in mineral cycling. Some examples are Alternaria, Colletotrichum and Trichoderma. Now this is a small brief about the fourth kingdom of Whittaker system of classification, Kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Plantae includes all eukaryotic chlorophyll containing organisms commonly called plants. A few members are partially heterotrophic, such as the insectivorous plants or parasites. Bladderwort and Venus flytrap are examples of insectivorous plants. This is important. And Cuscuta is a parasite. The plant cells have an eukaryotic structure with prominent chloroplast and cell wall mainly made of cellulose. You will study the eukaryotic cell structure in detail in chapter 8. Plantae includes algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Life cycle of plants have two distinct phases, the diploid saprophytic and the haploid gametophytic, that alternate with each other. The length of the haploid and diploid phases and whether these phases are free living or dependent on other vary among different groups in plants. This phenomena is called alternation of generation. You will study further details of this kingdom in chapter 3. Now this is a brief intro of Kingdom Animalia, the fifth and the last kingdom of Whittaker system of classification. So let's get started. This kingdom is characterized by heterotrophic eukaryotic organisms that are multicellular and their cells lack cell wall. They directly or indirectly depend on plants for food. They digest their food in an internal cavity and store food reserves as glycogen or fat. Their mode of nutrition is holozoic, by ingestion of food. They follow a definite growth pattern and grow into adults that have a definite shape and size. Higher forms show elaborate sensory and neuromotor mechanisms. Most of them are capable of location. The sexual reproduction is by copulation of male and female, followed by embryological development. Silent features of various phyla are discussed in chapter 4. So thank you so much guys for watching this video and listening so carefully. All the best.